Today's focus is Cantargia, a biotech company with targeted antibody therapy for cancer and inflammation. A very warm welcome to CEO Göran Forsberg and CMO Ignacio Garcia. Welcome.
Thank you so much.
Hello, good morning.
Göran, could you start by telling us about Cantargia and your project portfolio?
Yeah, so Cantargia is developing novel antibodies targeting a specific molecule called IL-1RAP, which is really exciting for a large number of different diseases. So it's relevant both in cancer as well as in autoimmune inflammatory diseases. And we have advanced furthest in development in cancer and especially in combination therapy. And I'm sure we're going to address that a little bit more in detail later on. But we reached phase 2A, which means that we're starting to get efficacy results. We are very encouraged with what we're seeing. And we're now, let's say, letting the data mature to take it into next phase if continue to look good. And then we have a second project, which is called CAN10, which is then in preclinical phase. It's more designed for treatment of autoimmunity because it has a different mechanism of action. And we selected two very difficult-to-treat indications with a big medical need, so myocarditis and systemic sclerosis. So that's really the company in a big nutshell.
And Ignacio, you are the CMO. Which of this project is the most promising?
Well, currently the most advanced project, as you know, is CAN04, that is already in the clinic for now more than 2 years. CAN10 is still in the preclinical time. So now the main focus is advancing CAN04 across several indications and try to learn about the capabilities as a new antitumoral, and making it as a proof of principle that the IL-1 pathway can be an effective anticancer, can be targeted effectively.
And could you give us a bigger view of the medical need and the demand for this type of antibodies?
Yeah, definitely. I mean, despite the advances in oncology in the recent years, the reality is that still for most patients progressing to immune checkpoint inhibitors, the reality is that they die from cancer. So cancer is still a big unmet medical need in solid tumors. And I'm not undermining the great advances, especially for diseases like melanoma that didn't have any effective treatment, let's say 7 or 10 years ago. So no matter what you try to develop, we need to advance clearly new drugs, new targeted agents. Nothing has really come out after the checkpoint inhibitors. So new pathways, new targets, new drugs are needed to increase and to increase the number of responses and the benefit to the cancer patients, no question.
I think we could add that in pancreatic cancer, which is the disease where we advanced the furthest, there is very limited treatment options for patients today. It is chemotherapy, which is only prolonging life with few months.
And Göran, a couple of weeks ago, Novartis released some negative news about their study, and we saw that Cantargia's stock fell. And could you describe the similarities or maybe the differences between your studies?
Yeah, absolutely. So first of all, the Novartis product called canakinumab has a, let's say, much more narrow mechanism of action than our CAN04 project. So we believe that we have several advantages compared to that. But there is still some relevance to understand Novartis compound and put it into perspective versus our development. So what Novartis did was that they had this IL-1 beta blocking antibody in development in cardiovascular disease, and you did a huge study in patient population that contained lots of smokers. realized that they saw very strong signal in let's say slowing down the development of lung cancer, and they moved the whole package into basically all the big different market segments in non-small cell lung cancer. And the segment that was, let's say, furthest away from the findings they had is the one that read out 2 weeks ago. And the only thing we know is that we didn't reach the primary endpoint, but we know very little if there was, let's say, some benefit or some signals to various patients. So we need to learn more about that. But Cantargia has really gone the other way, which is really looked into different indications and tried to find the right combination therapies. So we are combining with different agents than they do, and we are treating different types of patients, and we have a broader mechanism of action. So I'm not particularly concerned about the results from a Novartis trial. I'm very curious to learn more, but I think the CAN04 project stands on its own merits.
Yeah, from a mechanism of action and biology, we are very, very different. CAN04 is very different from canakinumab. Canakinumab targets a circulating protein, and we are targeting a protein that is produced, is present in the tumor cells on the surface. We are targeting directly the tumor cells and the surrounding environment. So they are very different. The actions that we expect go beyond what is expected from canakinumab, and it should not be unrealistic to consider that we can have a different efficacy, and we can drive also a greater effect in combination with chemotherapy. As Göran said, we are developing CAN04 in a canonical way. So Novartis jumped directly into pivotal trials without having any evidence of the anti-tumor benefit in established solid tumors in these patients. And we are proceeding in the traditional way of generating early evidence in patients with cancer and moving from there. That it has been proven as the most successful way to develop anti-cancer drugs.
Mm. Because looking at the stock that day, it almost felt like it was over, and the market almost felt that also, but that's not the case then.
No, definitely not. We're well financed. We have a strong clinical data, which I think are in completely different segments and different combinations than Novartis and canakinumab. So no, I'm not concerned by the results, and we know that we also have more data to present once they have matured. So hopefully they will continue to look good. I'm confident.
Mm-hmm. And you recently started a new study in CAN04. Why did you do that?
Yeah, so we have one trial that is known in pancreatic cancer with one of the global standard of cares, that is the combination of gemcitabine and Abraxane. This is almost split, 50% of patients can receive this treatment. And there is another global standard of care that is more complicated combination that is called FOLFIRINOX. I'm not going to enter in the details, but definitely it's almost given to the other half of patients. So we wanted to extend the interesting data that we observed with gemcitabine and Abraxane to check if we can also show similar positive results with this other combination. And this is the trial that we are now implementing. So to check if we can really target pancreatic cancer with the two main global standards of care.
Mm. And moving forward to CAN10, you recently showed us positive preclinical results in that project. Is this a big news?
Yeah, I think it's an important piece of a puzzle at this point in time. So what we we know that we have a very broad mechanism of action in CAN10, and we know that we can target a large number of diseases, but we have picked two diseases, myocarditis and systemic sclerosis, that are very difficult to treat today with very limited treatment options for patients. So generating convincing data showing that our drug has unique properties in the treatment of myocarditis, like we're doing now, and also being very safe in the initial toxicology study, which was part of that press release, is very important. And the data will be disclosed at the conference during second quarter. And we very much look forward to present them and having them discussed in the scientific community, because that's really guiding us to minimize risks in clinical development later on.
So the conference, when could we expect more news or more data from you?
So I think what the market is looking for is really around the clinical update in pancreatic cancer and non-small cell lung cancer. And in pancreatic cancer, we've been very concrete that we will have enough maturity in our data during second quarter to present that. In non-small cell lung cancer, we are a little bit behind, but hopefully it should come in not too far away. It's a little bit dependent on when we can close the recruitment in the ongoing trial. There are still a few patient slots left to fill. But once that's been filled, we will be clearer on the timelines of communication. And then obviously there are lots of new trials to start, and we will be very transparent on when we have passed different milestones. So anyone should expect a very interesting and good news flow during the second and third quarter.
Thank you so much, Göran Forsberg and Ignacio Garcia.
Thank you.
Thank you.